even the signature of whoever is we must also have a letter. I'm an accountant. You can also nominate an accountant to come and do it for you, a bookkeeper. They can come and do it for you, but they must also have a letter of nomination saying, we nominate this person to be part of the organization or to apply for us as the NPO, all right? Yes, because we don't want to see us so we don't want you to sit for 3 hours, 2 hours, only to find out you don't get it. That's the reason we are here. Okay, how to apply? I think we know that we all go to SARS with those forms and the supporting documents. You can go to our MTU, the mobile text unit, because we also register. And you can download our EI documents from our website. If on the internet, just download those documents and then fill them in and then bring them to SARS. Instead of going to SARS, getting the forms and come back again, or figure SARS, take the forms, we fill it for another 2 hours, and then. So make sure, if you've got internet access, download those forms, fill it in, and then bring them to SARS. Okay? And then, the compliance, né? So now you are registered as an NPO. And your NPO is going and you're getting funding from different companies. What is it that you as an NPO, you must do? Make sure that you submit. You have a return, like you might just submit a return, but I'll speak about that later on. You need to submit your annual financial statement, and we've got the IT12 EI. It's the return that you as an NPO will submit. It's IT12 EI. Yeah? Not because now you registered, you've got the number from SARS, then you are done. No, you still need to comply. You still need to come to SARS and submit those returns for women. Yeah? And then say you don't have, you didn't work, you need an affidavit. Actual companies, you can bring your zero returns and whatever. But now, say NPO or your organization didn't work, you can bring an affidavit with the bank statement confirming that the organization didn't work at all for that particular year. Yes or no? But if your organization did work, make sure you've got the financial statements. You clear, ne? So, and then basically again, keeping details updated, you could be able to must update our information with every time if they are changed. Constitution, they are changing every time. So let's make sure to favor with you. They are changing, go to SARS. And record keeping, make sure whatever you submit to SARS, whether it's personal income tax, whether it's your NPO, make sure you keep your records for 5 years. Not because now you're done with submission and then you just throw everything away. No. Make sure you keep all your documents for 5 years. Because auditors, they might call you again and say, all right, Mr. Scostana, can you bring your 2018 documents? Make sure that you file them. When I file them, if you have to file them in the system, there are many ways of finding. I cannot say in the financial, all right? And then we've got ETCS for good standing from an NPOs. A certain company wants to fund you as an NPO, and you are not compliant, and now you need a tax clearance. SARS cannot give you a tax clearance if you are not compliant. So your compliance goes a long way. Your compliance goes a long way because, believe you me, if you're not compliant with the DST, you need to comply with that. You know, your compliance goes a long way. So make sure whatever you're doing, you are honest and you're doing it the right way. Ne? So look at this. Now you need to get a tax clearance. You come to SARS and you've been having your NPO for how long? For 5 years. The company, if you don't fund, you have nothing. You come to SARS, those of tallers are actually the skin like and say, hey, sister, we get a tax clearance lab. Okay? When I go to the system and then when I capture your information, your company give a read. Once they hit the red button, that means you are not compliant. You are not paying your taxes. You are not submitting your return. There are reasons. So because I'm with you, then I will tell you what is happening with your tax clearance. So you cannot get tax clearance. So let's make sure that once you register as an NPO, or once you register as a company or anything else, make sure that you bring your returns. That's the reason why we're here. Well, but some people, they are scared of SARS. So SARS cannot bite. We don't bite. We are here to educate you. We are here to empower you. Which when you get there, you know what is expected of you. Let's try and submit our return in time and so that you can get your tax clearance certificate. We call it TCS match. Okay. So e-donation is what the 18A, section 18A. Section 18A, you are, as an organization, you are registered with SARS. Né? So your donors do benefit from giving you our donations. Hence, they want you to be registered with SARS. I mean, so once you are registered with SARS, you can issue your donors with an invoice. Okay, so that they, whenever they submit their personal income tax return, they get benefit of it. So let's try and make sure we register our organization. Alright, so there are legal requirements whereby we need the name. Obviously, when you register with SARS, then you come to us and you take it to a tax TEU. TEU, which is a tutorial. Then that our specialized section where they give you a unique number. Because all the agents are processing, we only give you a text number only. And then you get a different number when you go to and then after. And make sure that whenever you receive a call from our tax exemption unit, you make sure that you answer them. Because a simple mistake, I'm a gamma. So you register your NPO as Lugi, then Crash. And most young officers, now you're changing the name. Bank statement is not the same as the organization in the NPO certificate. See, they will take you back. Some they don't even check the names that they correspond. So when they get there to the TEU, and then they say, oh, because I'm a gun, our fan, and then they reject it. And maybe they will call you, okay, I'm a gun, I'll correspond to the bank statement, and on the certificate is not the same. So make sure that you answer your calls, and you go to search and submit whatever that is. Because if now they've contacted you, they will give their email address, put it, okay, to mail them, Spotify. And then you just email those documents, and then they process it, and you get the number. And then you get an SMS. Nice thing about us, they send you an SMS confirming that now you are registered as an NPO. Okay? Yes, what are you? Clear? All right, again, tell out Tata, even booze, or food, and booze. Okay, another thing, any question, you can. Now you are an employer, you can register for a PSVN if you are an employer. But I'm not going to go deep on that. You as an NPO, now you've got 15 employees, and now you are deducting tax from them. You can register for a PSVN. That is another topic for another day. But PSVN, you can register if you've got employees, and you've got a tax. Not necessarily you've got a tax, but you can register and a PSVN. So PSVN was now. You've got employees under you. Okay? I'm going to touch on our question if there are any other questions. And let's use again. They're going to stay forward. But I hope I get to start. Okay, I'm going to